Italy is pagan, especially, no, more South Italy. And the worship of the saints is more felt instead of the worship of Jesus.
Ragionare mia potente, fria via fatta da gente. Ragionare mio protettore, fria
Neapol słynie z ogromnej ilości kościołów i wyobraźcie sobie, że na tym placu budynki wyglądają całkiem normalnie, ale naliczyliśmy przynajmniej 5 kościołów. Tylko na tym jednym placu. Na pierwszy rzut oka w ogóle nie widać, że one tutaj są.
And so now we are in San Gregorio Romano, one of the most important places here in Naples to visit. All year long you can find the presepe. Presepe is the representation of Jesus Christ's birth. But in Naples, you know, we like to change something. So we don't use so much to represent only the birth of Jesus, but also something different. And if you just hate someone, you can put it on the toilet paper. For example, in Naples we ate mostly Juventus and stuff like this, and here you are.
Milan. No, this one is Milan. Yeah. Juventus.
Chociaż Maradona nie gra już od dawna, to jest czczone w Neapolu tak jak Bóg. Zresztą widać to na targowiskach, które wyglądają tak jak świąteczne. Są wizerunki Jezusa, są wizerunki świętej rodziny i pośród nich wizerunki piłkarzy. Jest to wszystko na jednym poziomie.
Cześć! We are in the square of Santa Maria Assunta, the Dome of Naples. The real name is Santa Maria Assunta, but everybody knows it as the Dome of San Gennaro. San Gennaro is one of the most important saint patron of Naples. You know that in Italy, I don't know in Poland, but in Italy every small town has its own saint patron. And Naples has got 29 saint patrons. And San Gennaro is the most important. This is dedicated to him. It's in Gothic style. But inside it's Baroccan style. The most important and curious thing that we have here in Naples is the blood of San Gennaro, the mixing of the blood of San Gennaro. And on September they do this kind of miracle. It's called Miracle of San Gennaro. If the blood is going to be mixed, it could be a good luck for the city. If the blood stays like this, maybe something bad will happen to the city. For example, in the 18th century, an earthquake, bad earthquake happened to the city. And so a lot of people say that it was fault of San Gennaro because the blood didn't mix anymore. So that's it. Now we are going to go inside to see the beautiful style of the church.
And they are celebrating the mass, so we can't, but the blood of San Gennaro is in the golden cup in front of the priest. Now you can see it because there is the priest.
Ringraziamo la Santissima Trinità, dichiarata San Gennaro, il padre produttore di questa città. Io credo in Dio Padre Onnipotente, creatore del cielo e della terra. È Gesù Cristo nostro Figlio, nostro Signore, il quale fu concepito.
You couldn't understand, but inside there were some old women that were singing the mass, but in a very particular way. In the first point, they say it in Neapolitan. They don't sing in Italian, half Neapolitan. And they speak to the saint in a familiar way. For example, they say, San Gennaro, come on, do us a miracle, come on. It's like in this way, and they scream, scream. For Neapolitan people, I think that is important because first thing is that religion in Italy, especially in South Italy, is very, very, very important, like Shinto religion in Japan. It's a part of their life of people. For young people now, yes, but not so much. But for older people, they feel the strong faith. They have a strong faith in it. So this is the first thing. The second thing is that they feel San Gennaro like part of the family, and for all the people is like a member of the family, a brother, and they ask him favors all the type, all the kinds of miracles. When something bad happens, they say, why San Gennaro, you did this to me? Why? Italy is pagan, especially, no, more South Italy. And the worship of the saints is more felt instead of the worship of Jesus. It's not misunderstanding what I'm saying. They have a strong faith in Jesus, of course, but also of the saints, because saints come from the mixture of the worship of pagan old times with the modern Catholic times. And so saints are like the impersonification, I don't know how to say in English, of the ancient gods pagan. And the Vatican City, I don't remember exactly, but they say that the worship of the saints so feel is not so good because it's like pagan. And so that's for this that they treat more San Gennaro than Jesus sometimes, like it was a kind of god, okay? In Naples we have a strong faith of religion, as I said before. For example, in this shop you can see San Gennaro, okay? Mm-hmm. And behind there is the picture with an old lady with a rosary in her hands. So this explains to you how to pray, how important is really Catholic religion here in Naples. In Naples they have a folklore, very particular folklore, that is not so Catholic. And so you can see the typical horn, how can I say it? The red horn typical of Naples, they say that it brings good luck to you. It's not Catholic, but in Naples we have this mixture between Catholic religion and typical folklore, like paganism, like pagan things, you know? And is you can put this on the door,
okay, guardalo.
To bring you good luck, to bring you good luck.
Eccoci qua, è questo Napoli. Napoli
this is Naples.
È la
religion and, and paganism, pagan.
È la nostra contraddizione.
Our contradiction.
San Gennaro's blood.
E guarda il people, guarda la gente lì.
Te światełka, które widzicie, kojarzą się ze świętami Bożego Narodzenia i w wielu dużych miastach możemy w grudniu w Polsce zobaczyć takie światełka. Natomiast tutaj są one związane z obchodami Dnia Świętego Gennaro, czyli tym cudem, o którym przed chwilą słyszeliście.
We are in Via Duomo, real the dome of Naples, and this is the first time actually after the Second World War that these lights, popular lights, were are in the street. In Naples, it's very common to have objects that brings you luck. We are obsessed with luck and stories like this. As you can see, there is a
Pulcinella, it is cornetine napoletana, the tradition Napoli. Yeah. It is good luck. Good luck.
Yeah, good luck. Yeah. There is a kind of legend that says that if you touch the nose of Pulcinella, it brings you luck. So we touch it. Why are we obsessed with this? Because there are some legends, some stories, but actually the most funny one is that when you look at the at the pepper, maybe the big one is better, it reminds the penis.
and penis, I don't know why, brings luck. In fact, when it's a tradition, when something bad happens, or you know, there are dead people, it's a tradition to do this, okay? Don't get me wrong, it's just a tradition. To do like this. It means, it makes you get good luck. I don't know why actually, but touching it, touching the pepper, reminds to touch your penis when something bad happens. This is the funniest story.
What about women?
Women. yeah, they can do it as well, yeah. They are just touching peppers. As I told you, we are obsessed with schools, and if you go to Cimitero delle Fontanelle, is a Fontanelle Cemetery, I think in English, you can find thousands and thousands of skulls and bones and everything related to that. And especially there, people used to play a lottery, to bet on a lottery, and they say that the contact with dead people is about dead people giving you the numbers of the lottery from the outside, the dead world, okay? So they know it better, so they come into your mind when you're sleeping in your dreams, and they suggest you the numbers. And then it's always good to touch the skull, then go to the lottery store and play these numbers, and let's hope to win something. Good school.
Neapol jest miastem, w którym sakrum wyjątkowo miesza się z profanum. I tak, oficjalnym patronem miasta jest oczywiście święty Gennaro, natomiast nieoficjalnie rządzi święty Diego.